Good news, mailbag fans. The postman's been working overtime and tons of stuff have showed up. So this weekend, you get a bonus mailbag. Let's take a look, see what all this stuff is. Okay, here's the first item. It just says electronic parts. Mysterious. Oh, I guess I'm gonna need a knife. Okay. What do we got here? Some kind of an Arduino. Oh, that's a Pro Micro. Okay, good. I ordered that one when I started doing this project here, which is the Nintendo NES controller that I'm wanting to convert. And those of you who remember it, I promise to get back to it. I'm just waiting for my teenager to actually get around to doing better code than what I was hacking together. And if you know anything about waiting for teenagers, this could take a while, but I will get back to it. I was calling it a Pro Micro. They're calling it a Leonardo. Regardless, it's an 18 mega 32 U4. The major difference between this and some of the other tiny Arduino stuff is that it can be a USB host all by itself. But they're more expensive and they're not as common, probably because they're more expensive than a Nano or a Pro Micro or Pro Mini or something like that. This one was $6.46 Canadian from World Chips with free shipping. All right, the next thing in is this, and can't even read underneath all these stickers what the customs declaration says. So let's have to figure it out the fun way. Ha! It seems to be Arduino day today. Couple of Arduino Nanos. Just, I guess, replacing stock from other projects that I've built. These are like all the ones I try and order. CH340 for the USB interface, because it just works. I don't need extra drivers or anything with my Linux computers. Which version is this now? So it's the 328. Okay. At one point, I got a couple of 128s, which worked fine. But I just have to keep in mind that I have to use the right settings in the IDE. If I keep using 328s, then I don't have to remember that. Which, and not having to remember extra stuff makes me happy. Since you can't have enough Arduino clone boards kicking around, especially cheap ones, here's two pieces of Arduino Nano. CH340 runs at 5 volts, 18 mega 328p. Two for $5.98 from Horizon Electronic.
All right. Next is electronic parts, it says. These are all fairly small packages, but hey, if they're going to do free shipping, I'm not going to order extra stuff. I'm just going to order what I want. Transistors? What are these guys? Why would I order four transistors? Oh, wait a minute. Are these Hall effect sensors? That I remember ordering. Hang on for a second. All right, then. I went and did a bit of digging and I found out with my magnifying glass and my dull eyes, this is in fact an AH3503 Hall effect sensor. which the data sheet says is a linear Hall effect sensor, as opposed to the digital kind. So this one just puts out a raw analog voltage when there's magnetism present, or a change in voltage, actually. So right now what I've got is I've got 5 volts across pins 1 and 2, and then my voltmeter on pin 3, and right now it's sitting at a nice comfortable 2.5 volts. But when I move this magnet, this is just off the back of a name tag, it was handy. Move this magnet in here, look at that, it drops down below a volt, and if I get it in exactly the right place, it goes way down to a tenth of a volt. But if I put that same side of that magnet on the other side of the Hall effect sensor, it goes up to over four volts. So it looks like, and then if I put, okay, so that was with this side of the magnet facing like that. Let's try it with the back of the magnet on this side now, and it goes up. So the opposite polarity of the magnet, or the opposite face, pole, I guess. I'm going to flip it over this way and put it there, and that drops down to just below a volt. That's cool. Now I'm guessing, I don't remember when I bought these, but I'm guessing that the reason that I picked these particular ones was because they do put out an analog voltage, so I can use them with discrete analog circuitry if I want to, or I can use them with the analog input pin on an Arduino. The digital ones, you of course need to use with digital circuitry. I've got lots of Arduinos kicking around here, that's not a big deal. But sometimes I just like to kick it old school and do something completely analog. So, there you go. Plus, they were cheaper. Okay, the Hall effect sensors. 5 pieces H3503 Hall effect sensor from LS110-1983. $1.21 for the 5 of them. Next thing is the biggest package I've got this time. It is terminal block, it says. So let's see what kind of a terminal block I ordered. Oh, clearly I ordered this from Banggood. Okay. Apparently they got a sale coming up. Whoop-de-doo. Actually, no, never mind. That's not coming up anymore, is it? Terminal block, 3-pin. Oh, I know what these are. We use these on some things at work. These are terminal block, 2-piece terminal blocks. So this side, you solder onto your circuit board permanently. And this side is a 3-terminal screw terminal block, which plugs into it. So you can wire this up separately, and you don't have to crane your head around or whatever to try and see in there. Or if you have multiple things that use the same type of power supply, you can undo and or unplug one and move the power supply around. I'm trying to remember what project I ordered these for, because again, I ordered them several months ago and they finally just showed up. Maybe I was going to use them with some of the optical sensors on the railroad. I'll have to start digging back in my notes and see what I was planning on doing. Anyways, 10 of those in that bag. Nice. I'll skip over to Banggood for a second. Here's the pluggable terminal blocks. 10 pieces. I bought the 3-pin. 10 of them were $2.48 Canadian. Let's see if it has anything about them down here. They're rated for 300 volts, 15 amps in dubious Chinese ratings. They claim to have a UL certification. I'm not going to pay too much attention to that. I'm not going to use it for high voltages at all. It's just going to be for low voltage DC stuff. But anyway, pretty good price. Okay, what is this now? Electronic Parts 100X2. US dollar 0.0202 cents worth of, yeah. I don't even know why I bother looking at the descriptions on those, because they're almost always complete lies. Oh, okay. These are the guts for making my own DuPont style cable connection pin things. Basically, this package is this metal piece here times 100. And this package is the female metal bit. Somewhere around here. Where are we here? Yeah, there we go. A while back, I got a bunch of 3-pin shells. Now, those I do know. Those are for servo motors and the optical sensors that I'm using on my railroad. So that I can just make up wiring harnesses, and I'm good to go. The 100 pin DuPont jumper cable wire mail pin connector. $1.27 from Good Module for the mails. And 99 cents for 100 of the same thing in female mode, also from Good Module. Next one, again. Canada Post has covered up the customs declaration, and I can't see what the lies are in there. Oh well, I'll just have to do this. There. All right, what have we got? Woohoo, it's a multi-pack, yay! Oh, all kinds of stuff. Excellent, let's get my chair in close for this. What do we got here? Some circuit boards, some LED boards. Some diodes, big honking diodes. If I remember correctly, those are Schottky diodes. Let me get them out of the package here. Oh, there's one that's not even, okay. 10SQ045. Pause. Okay, let's see what we can learn about these diodes here. Do-do-do-do-do. Yeah, 210 millivolts, 2/10 of a volt forward. That's definitely a Schottky diode. And I did a little bit of looking quickly, and the part number says, what does it say? 10045. So that's a 10 amp, 45 volt Schottky diode. Most of the eBay sellers call it solar diode, which makes sense for solar charging. I'm not remembering why I ordered them, other than that I don't have any Schottky diodes in stock. That might be the only reason. Five pieces of 10SQ045, 10 amp 45 volt Schottky rectifiers. Good quality, as opposed to the other kind that they sell, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, from Horizon Electronic, $1.21 for the five of them. Is there any more specs down here? Nope, just what it says up there. Okay, the next thing in here. More of these little breakout adapto boards for putting surface mount components into a dip format, so that you can put surface mount components on a breadboard to tinker with them and not have to mess around. This particular one is 14 pins, and it uses, or it's bidirectional, just like the ones that I showed you a few months ago. SSOP14 on that side and SOP14 on that side. This one is more of the same. Oh, okay, I see what they've done. So what do we got here? 4, 8, 12, 20 of them. Okay. Good, good. I can use those, because I think I've got some 14-pin ICs that I ordered at the same time, which I don't think I've seen yet.
20 pieces SOP 14 or SSOP 14 surface mount to dip adapter converter board, blah blah blah. $2.43, more or less, kind of, sort of. I didn't buy it from this guy. I bought it from Horizon Electronic, same as some of the previous things, as you know, because they all came out of the same package. But I couldn't find their listing anymore, because I ordered this eons ago. So, this will have to do to give pretty pictures of it. There's the dimensions. Isn't that nice? Okay. What else we got in here? Another Nano. It is Arduino Day. This one says it's a Nano 3, and it's a slightly different... A slightly different form factor than the other one. Let me just reach up here and find the other one that I opened earlier. So the one that I opened earlier has a CH340 on the bottom, and the ATmega on top. This one has them both on top and nothing on the bottom. That's interesting. Let me see if I can zoom in and see if that is, in fact, a 328. Can't read it. Where's my magnifying glass? Okay, that's a 168, okay. So remember what I was saying before about trying to or trying to standardize on 328s? Oh well, I'm guessing this was cheap and just using it to fill out an order, which is fine. Nothing wrong with variety. One more Nano. It was also in the same package from Horizon Electronic. And this is the one with everything on the same say it of the board, nothing on the underneath like the other ones did earlier. I'm not sure how much of an advantage of that might be. Maybe it's a little bit lower profile on the bottom. I don't know. Anyway, it was $2.69 from Horizon Electronic. And the other four packages here. These are little LED strips. Are these 2812? These are WS2812, aka NeoPixels, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in the strip, times 4. That's nice. I have some others around here somewhere. Some others that I just bought as individuals and stuck them together like that, which is fun to play with, but it's kind of awkward. These can easily mount. They've got screw holes. Or they can you just stick them down to stuff, I guess. However, they're not quite as versatile because you have to go in straight lines. But that's okay. They're fun to play with. And if you're putting them someplace for indirect light on stuff, to shine on things rather than just as indicator blinkies that you see directly, they're fine in that form factor. Also from Horizon Electronic was the 8 WS2812s on a board. I bought a bunch of them, but they were $1.53 a piece. The ones that I actually got had a white circuit board. The ones in the picture are a black circuit board. But it's the same thing. And I think the last one for today, we have component. Another bubble pack for... Whoa! What is this? Oh! I remember ordering these. These I bought
as an auction completely on a whim just because they were going for so cheap. And I thought they might be interesting to play with for model railroad animation or stuff. And guess what it is, just from looking at it? It is, or something small that I can point at it with. It is a little tiny four-wire stepper motor with a lead screw. Can I get any closer? Sorry about that. Ooh. Apologies for the motion sickness. So, there, yeah. Four-wire. A little tiny stepper motor. Lead screw with a little slug that moves back and forth on it. So I can feel that that's a screw. Oh, I guess. Put a little wire or something in there. That, there you go, yeah. And that acts as your, as whatever you're moving. Can you hear that? The thread there? Oh, wow. Gonna have to do some looking to see what voltages this thing is. So I'm guessing it's probably not going to use a very high voltage. Maybe lithium battery voltage, 3.7. Maybe 1.5 even. I don't know if I'll ever use them. It seems like a cool idea. I could animate something really tiny that needs to move a really small distance. Hang on, where's my ruler gone? A ruler that actually measures in millimeters. There it is. That's a millimeter scale there. So the whole thing is only like 12 millimeters long. The travel looks like it would be about 5 millimeters. Yeah, where'd it go? Neato. And finally, the 10 little micro stepper motors with a lead screw. 3.3 by 4.5 millimeters for DIY. Okay, that's actually not a bad picture of it. Let's zoom in even tighter. So, okay. Like I was saying, four wire stepper motor, lead screw, little plastic thingy that you have to put some kind of a notch of metal or something into to engage with the threads on the lead screw. 10 of them from Robot Home for 99 American pennies or $1.21 Canadian free shipping. Well, here we go. So the motor length is 4.5 millimeters, motor diameter is 3.3 millimeters, the shaft length, the rod length, is 7.5 millimeters. Seems a little generous, but and the actual working length of it is definitely shorter than that. Oh, this one's going to come in handy right here though for me, so I don't have to wring out the motor, which would save me all of a few minutes. Does it say what the voltage is, though? It does not. Well, I got 10 of them. I'll start low and I'll work up until the smoke comes out, and then I'll back off a quarter turn. And there's all the goodies from today's mailbag. There's going to be some fun winter projects in this pile. Stay tuned. More mailbags to come sooner than you think.